Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. This is Meghna, and let me just start off by saying that this video is going to be a really long one, so just grab anything and everything that you want to snack on, and also grab your debit card, your credit card, whatever card, and your phone if you're watching this video on your laptop, because I know that you're going to want to buy at least one of these lipsticks. Let me straight up mention that I got these lipsticks in PR. I did not buy these lipsticks, but these opinions are my own. I'm not really like biased or anything. If it's bad, it's bad, and if it's good, then it's good. So without any further ado, let's just begin with the video. Been trying to change what I've been trying to say. Words don't come straight from my head to my mind. It's such a shame that it fell out of place. Was never me that was bringing you down. This shade is called Sandy Mauve, and true to its name, it is like a classic true mauve shade. It's like more like a like a grayish mauve kind of shade. Obviously an opaque layer of this shade is going to wash out like dusky skin tones, like a tan to dark deep dark skin tones. I think this shade is more suited for like fair to medium fair sort of skin tones, and not really for dusky skin tones. So this is what the sheared out version of Sandy Mauve looks like. I have lined my lips with this lip liner from NYX. It's called Mahogany. This is like a pinky brown sort of liner. I felt like it goes really well with this shade. This is what the liner looks like. It's a pinky brown shade. I think now that I've sheared it out, I really like this shade. It's really pretty. It looks like light pink shade, but like really pretty, something that can be worn on an everyday basis, like an office wear basis. You can clearly see that my pigmentation is peeking through, and it makes the shade look more purpley than it is, but I really don't mind. I'm really happy with this shade. Obviously it doesn't go with this red kurti that I'm wearing, but otherwise if you just look at this, I feel it looks really pretty. Because I have like all the shades with me, I didn't really know what to do with the shades that wash me out. So I tried this technique, and I think it really works. Okay, if you have any lipsticks that don't suit you, then do try this technique. Just sheer it out and line it with a matching sort of lip liner or a little bit darker lip liner, and you'll be good to go. Like, it looks really pretty, because I know how hard it can be to find that perfect pinky nude, or perfect sort of my lips but better kind of shade for dusky skin tones especially. But yeah, this is really good trick. Okay, so yeah, this was the shade Sandy Mauve. This shade is called Vintage Lotus, and this is a baby pink sort of shade. Again, this shade kind of washes me out. I've got this extra tan on my face, so I'm like darker than usual, and thus it is kind of washing me out. I think the shade, like an opaque layer of the shade, would suit fair to, you know, tan sort of skin tone. This shade might wash out dark or dusky skin tone, like it is kind of washing me out. Though you are not able to tell on camera that it is washing me out, but as I'm looking into the mirror, it feels like I can see that it is kind of washing me out because of that extra tan that I've got. Now let me show you what it would look like if I had to, you know, sheer out this lipstick. So this is what the sheared out version of Vintage Lotus looks like, and it looks like a really, really, really nice pretty pink. Also, again, I've lined my lips with the NYX lip liner in the shade Mahogany. I mean, I don't really know of any shades that would look like this on dusky skin tone, but a sheared out version and along with this lip pencil, I think it works like magic. I really like this shade. It's a very pinky toned shade and it does not wash me out anymore. So, I mean, amazing. This looks really pretty now. So yeah, this was the shade number 7 with this Lotus. This shade is called Pink Granite, and this is more like, you know, like a pink, but it has more earthy tones to it. I feel it is blue toned, but it has more earthy tones to it. This one you can see it's much of a like a lighter pink, and this one is more like a pink with sort of like earthy tones, like a blue toned pink with earthy tones. It also, I think, kind of has like a bit of a peach tone to it, like a slight bit of peach tone to it, even though it's like a blue based sort of pink. So let's just see what it looks like sheared out and with the lip liner. So this is what Pink Granite looks like, oh, just sheared out and without like a lip liner. I don't necessarily think that it requires a lip liner, but if you are of like a deep dark complexion, then you might need one. So just for reference, I think it's better if I you know, line my lips and show you how that would look like. So this is what it looks like after lining my lips with again the NYX lip pencil in the shade Mahogany. So yeah, this was the shade Pink Granite. This shade is called Pink Salt, and this is like a light pink, but more like a corally toned light pink. I feel it is very warm toned. Obviously, again, it washes me out. It is meant for, I think, fair to medium fair sort of skin tone. I think not even medium fair, just fair skin tones. It is definitely very warm toned. It completely washes me out. So yeah, this was the shade Pink Salt. This shade is called Venus Rose, and again this is another coral pink shade, but it is kind of deeper than the earlier shade that I had swatched, that was Pink Salt. You can see the difference. This is more warm toned and you know, more corally, and this one was like more pinky compared to corally. So yeah, that's the difference between Pink Salt and Venus Rose. Obviously, it again, this shade also washes me out. It would suit fair to medium fair sort of skin tones. I think it's not meant for dusky skin tones because it does wash me out. So let's just see what it would look like, you know, kind of sheared out and with a lip liner. So this is what Venus Rose looks like once sheared out and lined with a lip liner. This is like a chocolate brown lip liner from Colourpop, and the name is Petal Please. So let me just show you what it looks like. So this is what it looks like. It's like a chocolatey brown sort of a lip liner. I'm obviously really liking this combination. You can see it looks so pretty. So yeah, this was the shade Venus Rose. This shade is called Sandy Rose, and this is a nice nude shade. Like I think this is more like a neutral nude shade. It's not warm or cool toned, it's quite neutral. This feels more like a peachy nude rather than a pink based nude. It does kind of wash me out. So this is what Sandy Rose looks like after lining my lips with this chocolate lip liner in the shade Petal Please. I think now it is more wearable. It looks really nice. It looks very subtle, like a really nice perfect nude for a dusky skin tone. I mean with a lip liner, okay, not just on its own. But it looks really, really, really nice. So yeah, this was the shade Sandy Rose. This shade is called Cinnamon Nude, and this is again, this is like a brown toned nude shade. You can see this is This was more like a peachy nude. This is more like a neutral brown tone nude. Wearing this lipstick in person, if you see, it looks like I have no lips, kind of, you know. So I think to suit like my skin tone, or you know, for me to be able to wear this shade, I feel like I have to, like I must use a lip liner. So for this shade, I'm going to use the lip liner from ColourPop. It's actually called CTRL Control. So I'm just going to line it and I'm going to see what that looks like. So this is what the shade Cinnamon Nude looks like after I've lined my lips with this dark brown lip liner. It is much more wearable now. I think the dusky skin tone girls can or guys can wear this shade after applying like a dark brown or like a chocolate lip liner. Now it is looking really nice. It is looking really pretty. So yeah, this was the shade Cinnamon Nude. Next up, the shade is called Nude Mocha, and this is like a mocha shade. It is a nudie shade. It is very warm toned. It kind of washes me out. Again, I cannot differentiate between the boundary of my lips and you know, the rest of my face. I'm just not feeling it even with a lip liner, so not a fan of this shade. Yeah, so this was the shade Nude Mocha. This shade is called Peachy Nude, and I think this shade is only meant for fair skin tone, not even medium fair skin tones, just fair skin tone. It is a peachy nude, but it is a very, very extremely light peachy nude. So dusky skin tones should avoid this shade, or even like, you know, tan skin tones should avoid this shade. So yeah, this was the shade Peachy Nude. This shade is called Nude Lily, and this is straight up a very light pink based nude shade. I feel it's extremely light. Again, this is going to suit a fair skin tones. Obviously, it completely like washes me out. You should really skip those last two shades, that is Nude Lily and I think Peachy Nude. Before we move ahead with the video, let me just talk about this special app. It's called Pankhuri, and it's a women's community to know, glow and grow. You know how we always want to know things about makeup and hair care and skin care and beauty and home remedies. This app is like a one-stop place for all this. All you need to do is just ask a question on this app, and the experts related to those particular topics that you have asked questions about are going to answer you in an instant. Pankhuri also provides you with masterclasses on beauty and skincare, and they even have workshops on how to make soaps and shampoos so that you can learn all these things while sitting at home, please. Also, another awesome feature is after you complete these masterclasses, you will be given a certificate. And if you've missed any of these classes, you can always go back and check the class recording. So do go ahead and download the Pankhuri app, and to know more about it, please check the link in the description box below. This shade is called 01 Ladybird Red, and this is a straight up maroon. Okay, at first when I saw this like in the tube, and when I applied it and when it was, you know, still wet, I thought this would be like a deep red, but no, this is a straight up maroon. It's really pretty. If you're looking for like a true maroon, then this would be a nice shade, because usually maroons have, you know, like those really brown tones to them, or like rusty tones to them. This one I feel is a very pretty nice maroon. On me, it doesn't look as bright and bold because obviously I have dusky complexion. But if you are a fair tone or medium skin tone or even tan skin tone, then this is going to look really lovely. It's going to look like a dark red, like a dark maroon. This is a really pretty shade which will suit all skin tones. And also, let me tell you that this is a very neutral maroon shade. It's not warm or it's not cool toned. It's quite neutral is what I feel. So yeah, this is the shade Ladybird Red. Next up, the shade is called number 02 Fiery Ruby. And this is like a really warm toned red. I don't really like these kind of reds, because firstly, it makes my teeth look yellow, and secondly, it makes, like, especially for dusky skin tones, I'm saying, it makes the area around my mouth look even more darker and dull, and it's just, I feel like I look ugly. I lose all confidence in myself when I wear these kind of shades. So I'm really not a fan of these shades. And if you feel the same way about warm toned reds, and if you have a dusky complexion, then I would recommend you to stay away from this particular shade. I prefer the maroon shade better. I think it was Ladybird Red. Yes, so I prefer this shade better than this one. And that's all that I have to say about this shade. I'm not really a fan of this one. So yeah, this was the shade number 02 Fiery Ruby. This next shade is called number 03 Scarlet Poppy, and this is my kind of red. This is a bright bold red with a pink undertone. Obviously it's going to suit all skin tones. These kind of shades remind me of Mimosa by Sugar Cosmetics. Then there is Amour by Milani, Amour Matte Lip Creams. Then there is Cherry Moon by Sephora. All these pink toned lipsticks, I think I should do like a comparison swatch video of all these, you know, pink toned red lipsticks. Maybe not a video, maybe just a post, and I will post it on my Instagram. So be sure to follow me on my Instagram if you are not following me already. This kind of red is like a universally flattering kind of shade. Obviously it's going to suit all skin tones. You can see it brightens up my complexion in an instant. I love how this looks on me. If you are a fan of bold lipsticks, you would know what I'm talking about. So yeah, this was the shade number 03 Scarlet Poppy. Next up, the shade is 04 Terra Red, and this is a peachy corally shade. I wouldn't necessarily call this a red. If you want to call this red, then it would be like a very extremely muted red with peach coral sort of undertone. I wouldn't recommend this shade for anybody who has a deeper skin tone than mine. I'm barely hanging on to this shade without it actually washing me out, but I feel it would do better for me, like to apply a brown lip liner or something. So this is what Terra Red looks like after shearing it out and with a darker lip liner, like a dark brown lip liner. Personally, I feel it still doesn't look all that great. I could easily pass this this lip shade. It's not meant for, I think, really dusky skin tones. Maybe tan skin tones can carry it off well, but dusky skin tone, NC45, 46 and so on, I don't really think it's meant for us. Even after shearing it out, it doesn't really look that great, so it's a no from me. So yeah, this was the shade number 04 Terra Red. Next up, the shade is called 05 Tropical Fuchsia, and this is a true fuchsia which actually suits dusky skin tones. Like, I really like this. If you are of my complexion or even like 1-2 shades deeper than me, I think this is going to suit you. I think like really deep skin tones, this shade might, you know, make the area around your mouth look even more dark. But I think if you're of my complexion or at least even 1-2 shades darker than me, it's going to look good on you. I for a fact really like this shade, and I feel like it's really difficult to find that exact fuchsia that actually suit dusky skin tone, and I feel this is really nice for dusky skin tones as well. So yeah, this was the shade number 05 Tropical Fuchsia. Next up, the shade is called number 10 Pink Pepper, and this is like a mauvey pink sort of shade. I wouldn't necessarily say that it is a nude shade because it's a straight up pink shade, but it does have, you know, a little bit of like mauvey undertones to it is what I feel. But it looks really pretty on dusky skin tone. If you have like a really deep skin tone, then I would suggest that you use a lip liner with this shade because this might wash you out. But if you're of my skin tone, you can see it looks stunning. It looks really pretty, like a subtle mauvey pink sort of. And if you're of a fairer complexion than me, then I think this is going to look like a deeper sort of, like a deeper pink on you. So yeah, this was the shade number 10 Pink Pepper. This shade is called number 12 Nutmeg Nude, and this is like a milk chocolate brown sort of, but like a warm milk chocolate brown, if you know what I mean. It will make your teeth look yellow. Again, I think this could be considered a nude only for dusky skin tones. On me, it doesn't really wash me out, but I feel like it doesn't really define my lips, like the boundary of my lips, like where it begins and where it ends, it kind of disappears. So I do feel like I need to apply like a dark brown lip liner, so I'm just going to do that, and let's see how that looks. So this is what my lips look like after lining it with this lip liner from NYX, and it's the shade Coco. I think it looks much better now. It looks more wearable now. It looks more rich now that I've refined my lips. So yeah, this was the shade Nutmeg Nude. This next shade is called number 14 Dark Currant, and it's more like a burgundy wine sort of shade. Obviously it looks exceptionally good on dusky skin tone. I think on lighter skin tone this is going to look quite vampy, but on dusky skin tone it goes so well with our complexion. I mean, some of these shades, right, like really, some of these dark shades, they go so well with dusky skin tones, I'm telling you. Like this one right here, if you're looking for something like this, like a deep dark wine sort of shade without any brown undertone, let me also mention that this one does not have any like brown undertone to it, because most of the burgundy shades, as I said, even for the Ladybird red one, the maroon shade, the first shade that I swatched, it does not have any, like, you know, sort of like brown undertone, very through shades kind of. So yeah, if you're looking for those kind of shades, then do give this one a shot. And yeah, this was the shade number 14, Dark Currant. Next up, this shade is called number 15, Berry Eclipse, and this is a very extremely dark, sort of like a brown, like a chocolate brown, really dark chocolate brown, but with red undertone, almost like ox blood sort of shade. It's really vampy, really dark. You can see, I think it's going to look even more darker on, you know, fairer skin tones. But obviously it's going to suit all skin tones. If you like these dark chocolate brown sort of shades with you know, red undertones, then you will definitely like this one. These kind of shades, usually they go on quite sheer and patchy, but this one was not sheer and patchy. It went on quite smoothly. I did not have to, you know, put in extra efforts to get an even coat. So yeah, this was the shade number 15, Berry Eclipse. Next up, the shade is called number 16, Dusky Grape, and this is a very dark plum berry sort of shade. It's extremely dark, it's vampy. Even for my skin tone, it looks quite vampy, very 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 dark. Obviously it's going to suit all skin tones. I do like these shades, as I already mentioned, they look gorgeous on dusky skin tones. It kind of looks like the previous shade that I'd swatched, that was Dark Currant, but this one is more pinky purpley, and Dark Currant was more like reddish, sort of almost reddish. So yeah, this was the shade number 16, Dusky Grape. Alright you guys, that was it for the swatches and the shade description. Now moving on to the review. So these lipsticks retail for ₹875 for 5 ml of product. Now let me talk about the things that I like and the things that I don't like. So firstly, let me start with the things that I like. First thing that I like is that it is clean beauty. That means it is free of all toxins and parabens and all the things that are harmful to your skin. Even in, you know, minuscule quantities, they are free of that. They are clean beauty, which is really good, okay? Secondly, I feel they do last a decent amount of time, and I do like them. And even if they fade away when you're eating and stuff, it will fade away from the center. But the fading away process of these lipsticks is not ugly, you know what I mean? And you can quickly reapply and it will not look crusty, or it will not look thick or anything like that. Reapplication is a breeze. Third thing that I like is the number of shades. There are 20 different shades that you can choose from, and I am proud to say that I finally found a pink nude for me, for a dusky skin girl like me. And lastly, the thing that I like, I would say, is the price point. Now hear me out, I know you would say $875, that's not good, I mean that's like too high for me. But these lipsticks, quite often they go on sale, so when they go on sale, the offers are like buy two get one, buy one get one, so you can easily snatch those offers. I mean, if you snatch those off, you'll get each lipstick for around ₹450, which I think is a very decent deal. Like ₹450 for 5 ml of product, that's going to last you a very long time, trust me. I think that's a really good deal. Now coming to the things that I do not like about these lipsticks. Firstly, again, the price point. Some people, if they want to buy these lipsticks and they don't really want to wait for the offers, the buy one get one offer or the buy two get one offer, then they might find that expensive. But I would strongly suggest you wait for those kind of offers. Secondly, they are heavily fragranced, I would say. The fragrance is more like, you know, like that synthetic watermelon fragrance is what I get when I open the tube. But once you apply it and once you let it sit for like 2 minutes, you are not going to get that smell anymore. So it doesn't really last that long. And the last part that I kind of feel people might have an issue is that once you apply them and once they dry out, they do feel kind of tacky. Like you can see, it's a little bit sticky, but it's not like ew so tacky. It's not that, okay? It's like my lips feel juicy, like, you know, they feel plump, that kind of tacky. But I shouldn't actually say tacky, because tacky is always used as a reference for a bad thing. These are more like plumping kind of lipsticks. Like my lips feel fuller when I'm wearing these lipsticks. So again, I don't really feel like that's a con. That was all about the things that I liked, and I feel some people might not like about these lipsticks. Also, if you have not downloaded the Pankuri app as yet, please go and download it. If you want to learn a new skill or get to know something more about makeup, hairstyle and so on, then absolutely do download it. That brings us to the end of this video, you guys, and I will see you in my next swatch video. Till then, bye-bye.